So we'll discuss problems today on set theory. Okay. So let A and B are two finite sets such that n of A is equal to number of elements in A is equal to 20, number of elements in B is equal to 28. So if number of elements in A intersection B is equal to 36, find what are the number of elements in A union B is equal to 36. Find number of elements in A intersection B. Okay. So see this Venn diagram. What is number of elements in A? So it will include all elements in A. So whichever common to B also will be included in A. Yes or no?
Ma'am, Venn diagram is not visible, ma'am.
Is it so? Is it visible now?
No, ma'am, you should move somewhat. Somewhere you should move, ma'am. Left side.
Okay. Is it visible now?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Half, only half is visible, ma'am. The last Venn diagram is missing.
Okay.
Right side.
I'll move it a little bit. Now, ma'am? Now is it visible?
No, ma'am. Only two. Ah, yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Now, you see here? Number of elements in A is equal to number of elements A will include all the elements A along with the elements common to B also. Okay. Number of elements in B will include all elements B including number of elements in A also. Okay. Now what is intersection? Intersection will be having whichever is common to both A and B. The elements which are common to both A and B will be included in the intersection part. Yes or no? So, now they have given how many elements we have in the A union B. Okay, what is A union B? It will include all the elements of A which is common to B plus the number of elements in B which is not common to A, because this intersection part will be included only once. When we take union, this intersection part will be included only once. Whereas when we take elements of A, we'll be taking that intersection part one time, and when we consider elements of B, this intersection part will be considered second time. Two times it will be considered. When we take union, this intersection part will be considered only once. Okay. Now, how do you get only this intersection part? We get in this intersection part by adding number of elements in A plus number of elements in B, so that this common part will be included two times. Okay, now what we do, we subtract that with A union B. If you subtract with A union B, what happens here? We will be getting only this part of intersection. Okay, understood? Because A includes this common part, B will also include this common part. Now this common part is included two times. When we consider union, this common part will be considered only one time. Okay, now if you subtract number union from number of elements in A plus the number of elements B, we get what is the intersection. Okay, so that is the formula. What is the formula here? Number of elements in A union B is equal to number of elements in A plus number of elements in B, because union will include only that intersection part one time. But if when we consider number of elements in A, that intersection part will be included one time. Number of elements in B, it will be included second time. Okay. Now we have two times it is included. Now if you subtract with number of elements in A intersection B, then that intersection part will be considered only one time. Okay. So we'll be using this formula. That is, number of elements in A union B is equal to number of elements in A plus number of elements in B minus number of elements in A intersection B. Okay, so using this formula, so what are the things given? It is given that number of elements in A is given, number of elements in B is given, number of elements in A union B is given, so that you can find out what are the number of elements in A intersection B. Okay. So, see this problem. Next problem, the same similar problem. Here, number of elements in A minus B is given. Number of elements in A minus B. What is A minus B? A minus B will have all the elements of A which are not present in B. So it will not include the intersection of A union A and B. Okay. A minus B does not include intersection of A and B. So A minus B will be having all elements of A which are not present in B. So how many elements we have? 18 elements. Now, what is A union B? A union B includes all the elements of A, all elements of B, and the intersection of that will be included only one time. Okay. And A intersection B is what? A intersection B will be equal to only which is common to both A and B. Now find out what is NB. Okay. So what is the formula we use here? The number of A union B is equal to N of A minus B plus N of A intersection B plus N of B minus A. Okay. So what is A union B? For example, you see here. It is given like this. Okay. So these are the elements of A. Okay. These are the elements of B. What are the things given, ma? It is given that, okay. So, what is this part? Can you tell me what is this part, anybody? What is this part? What I shaded? What is that part?
A minus B.
Yes. A minus B, ma'am.
Very good. It is A minus B. Okay. And what is this part? This part is what?
B minus A.
Very good. Okay. Now, what is this part?
A intersection B.
So it is A intersection B. What is that we have to find out? We have to find out what is A union B. What is A union B? A union B is equal to, now we have, what is this? It is equal to number of elements in A minus B plus number of elements in B minus A plus number of elements in intersection part. Yes or no? Can we write like that? So this equation now can be written like this. Okay. So that is this one. Any doubts here? Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So this part we'll be using here. Okay. So that is why number of elements in A union B is equal to number of elements in A minus B, number of elements in A intersection B, plus number of elements in B minus A. Now, what are the things given in the problem? What are the things given? A minus B is given. A union B is given. Okay. And A intersection B is given. Okay. So, A minus B is given. A union B is given. A intersection B is given. Now, we'll find out what are the number of elements in B minus A. Okay. Now, if you find out what are the elements in B minus A, how do you find out number of elements in B? What is the formula to find out number of elements in B? Now we got number of elements in B which are not present in A. What is B minus A, ma? Number of elements in B which are not present in A. Yes or no? Now tell me, how do you find out number of elements in B? Only in B. So what is that? We should add, see here. We want this complete portion. This should also become, see here. Okay. Now, what is our interest? Our interest is that we have to find out this complete region. What is this, ma? This is number of elements in B minus A plus number of elements in intersection part. That is A intersection B. That gives us what are the number of elements in B. So, what is number of elements in B? It is number of elements in A intersection B plus number of elements in B minus A. So, from that, we will be finding what are the number of elements in B that is equal to 52. Is it clear? Any doubts here? Any doubts here now? See this problem, next problem. So it is given like this. So in a group, 60 people, in a group of 60 people, 27 like cool drinks, 47 like hot drinks, and each person likes at least one of two drinks. How many like both the coffee and tea? Okay, so set A is set of people who likes cold drinks and B likes hot drinks. Okay, what is that union? Union is nothing but A union B, the group of the people. Total number of the people will be equal to 60. Okay, number of elements like cold drink is 27. Number of elements like hot drink is 42. Okay. Each person like at least one of the, now we have to find out intersection. Okay. Each person like at least one of the two drinks. How many like both the coffee and tea? Okay. So we have to find out intersection part. This formula we already discussed. How do you find out intersection part? Who will like both coffee and cold drink and hot drink? Okay. Cold drink and hot drink is A intersection B is given as N of A plus N of B minus N of A union B. From that, we will be getting 9. Any doubts in this problem? Okay. Now see this. In a group of 100 persons, 72 can speak English. 43 can speak French. How many can speak English only? Okay. How many can speak French only? How many can speak both English and French? Okay, here also the same thing. A union B is given. Okay, so what is A minus B? A minus B is the set of the people who speaks English only, not French. Okay, means the intersection part is removed. B minus A is nothing but the people who speaks French and not English. Okay, and what is A intersection B? A intersection B, the set of the people who speaks both French and English. Okay. So to do this, first we have to find out what is A intersection B. To find out A minus B. To find out A minus B, what you have to do? We have to find out A intersection B. It is same as this. Okay. Once we have to find out A minus B. To find out A minus B, we have to subtract number of elements in A minus number of elements in A intersection part, A intersection B part. Okay, subtract A intersection B from A so that we will be getting what are the elements present only in A, which is not common to B. Okay, so same thing here also. Okay, so first we have to find out what is A intersection B. So that is the people who speak both English and French. Okay. So once we find out that, okay, then we will be subtracting A intersection B from A so that we will be finding the people who speak only English, not French. Okay. So like that, see now N of A is equal to what? N of A minus B plus N of A intersection B. So this we have discussed in the previous problem, the same thing here. Okay. N of A minus B is equal to now N of A minus N of A intersection B. So it is equal to 57. Okay. Similarly, N of B minus A is equal to N of B minus N of A intersection B. So that is equal to 28. So that number of people speak English only is equal to how many people speak only English? 57. How many people speak only French is 28. Is it clear? Do you have any doubts in this problem? Students, please respond, no? Do you have any doubts in this problem?
No, ma'am. It's clear. Ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you. What about others? So along with the identities, whatever we have discussed before, we have this also. So that is number of A intersection B, number of elements in A intersection B is equal to number of elements in A plus number of elements in B minus number of elements in A union B. Okay, so this part we have, and we have this also. Number of elements in A is equal to this, and all we have verified with the Venn diagram. Okay, whenever you have this type of problems, you should verify with the Venn diagram. Okay, so just now we have verified with the Venn diagram, no? The same procedure you have to follow. Okay, so these are the important identities. Whenever we have to solve this type of problem, we should use this type of identity. Only thing, you should draw the Venn diagram, okay, and you need to find out the relation between the things given. Okay, from that you have to find out the result. So this and all, these are the some of the important problems. Okay, so last class we were discussing about the probability, yes or no? So we discussed this problem. Okay, so what is probability of, what is the probability that I will choose a red marble? Okay, so it is given like this. Okay, you have a bag with, in this bag we have 3 red marbles, 2 white marbles, 1 purple marble and 4 green marbles. Okay, now what is that we have to do? What is the probability that I will choose a red marble? Okay, so how do you find out that? So number of red marbles divided by total number of marbles in the bag will give us the probability of choosing a red marble. Okay, so in this case, see here, how many red marbles are there in the bag and how many marbles are there, total number of marbles we have in the bag, it is equal to 3/10. So it is the probability of choosing red marble. Okay, and the last class we also discussed what is experiment. Okay, and we have discussed what is sample space. Okay, so we have discussed what is sample space, what is experiment, all this we have discussed in the last class. So experiment is a random experiment. If its outcome cannot be predicted, okay, then it is called a random experiment. Okay, a single performance of a random experiment is called trial, and it has a outcome. Okay, so flipping a coin, exam marks, assembly time, post gates, all these are the examples for the random experiment. And what is sample space? We have discussed that all possible outcomes in an experiment is called sample space. All this we have discussed, and we have discussed that using these two, experiment and sample space, we will be defining the probability. Okay, so probability is occurrence of likeliness of any event is called probability. Okay, these are all the examples of sample space we have discussed in the last class. Okay, so here probability of any outcome is between G, and this also we have discussed, probability of any outcome is between 0 and 1. Okay, and if you have, say for example, k number of outcomes, the probability of all this k number of outcomes will be equal to 1. Okay, this and all we have discussed. Okay, and we also discussed what is probability. So set of probability values for an experiment with a sample space S is equal to, say here, what are the outcomes? O1, O2, so on, On, consist of some probabilities, P1, P2, so on, Pn. This we have discussed. Okay, if you take, what is the probability of particular outcome? O1 is given as P1. Probability of particular outcome, O2, is given as P2, like that. What is that we have discussed? The probability value lies between 0 and 1. Now, if you add all these probabilities, what is that we will be getting? Will be getting equal to 1. Okay, so probability of occurrence of any particular outcome, OI, occurrence of any particular outcome, OI, is equal to PI. Okay, so this and all we have discussed in the last class, and we also discussed what is probability. Probability is measure of how likely an event or outcome occurs. Okay, and we have discussed that different probabilities will have different types of different values. Okay, different outcome will have different probabilities. Okay, and here this also we have discussed. Probability of an event can be explained like this. Certain event, okay, this is going to be happen. Likely, the event will probably happen, but not definitely. Unlikely, the event will probably not happen, but it might happen. Impossible, even is definitely not going to happen. These are the four ways to describe the probability. Certain means what? The event is definitely going to happen. Likely means what? The event will probably happen, but not definitely. Unlikely, the event will probably not happen, but it might happen. Okay. Impossible, the event is definitely not going to happen. So these are the four ways to describe the probability. And last class we have discussed how do you predict the results. Okay. So using that example, we have explained all this. Okay. So this also we have discussed in the last class, and we have discussed this problem. Okay. Now we see that probability model has two components. So what are that? A sample space and assignment of probabilities related to each outcome. Okay. So sample space is nothing but what? It will be having all the elements present, all the outcomes. Okay. All possible outcomes of a particular experiment will present in the sample space. Okay. So whatever each element of a sample space is called outcome. Okay. So, and there is a probability for each outcome. Okay. So the sample space we denote with S, and a set whose elements are all probabilities that possibilities that can occur. Okay. So set S is nothing but all possible outcomes. Yes or no? That only we have discussed. Each element of a S is called outcome. Okay. Probability of outcome is a number and has two properties. Okay. Probability assigned to each outcome is non-negative. That only we have discussed. Okay. So the probability value should be between 0 and 1 for any particular outcome. Okay. So what is the probability value for any particular outcome will be? It should be between 0 and 1. It is non-negative number. Okay. And similarly, the probability of all sum of all probabilities equal to 1. That only we have discussed. Okay. Say outcome 1 is having probability 1, outcome 2 is having probability 2. Okay. Like that we have n outcomes, so that we have n probabilities for each outcome. Okay. If you add all outcomes, okay, probabilities of all outcomes, its value will be equal to 1. It means that what? The probability of a sample space is equal to 1. What is probability of a sample space will be equal to 1, because sample space will have all possible outcomes. Okay. If you add all possible outcomes probability of all possible outcomes, what is its value will be equal to 1 only. Is it clear? So whatever discussed in the previous, see here in the previous slide, okay, the same thing we have explained here. This is the thing we have discussed, no? To take any probability, its value is between 0 and 1. If you add all the probabilities of each outcome, the value will be equal to 1. The same thing here we have explained. Okay, the same thing here in the statement wise. Okay, and see here. So what is sample space? So using this diagram, we can explain what is sample space. Okay, the sample space is set of all possible outcomes. Okay. What is simple event? Individual outcomes are called simple events. Okay. The set of outcomes, okay, it is called event. But for example, when you throw a die, what are the possible outcomes here is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. There are 6 outcomes. All those 6 outcomes are present in S. That is called sample space. All 6 outcomes. Yes. Okay. What is simple event? Simple is event is individual outcome is called simple event. For example, we have an event of getting even value when you throw a die? What is the probability of getting even value when you throw a die? So what is this event, particular event consist of? All even values in the sample space, that is 2, 4, 6. Okay, so a set of values from the sample space will be calling it as event. Event is any collection of one or more simple events, okay? So using this diagram, we can explain what is sample space. It is it consists of all possible outcomes of an experiment. Okay, each possible outcome is called simple event, okay? And collection of simple events, okay? For example, what is the probability of getting the value more than 3 when you throw a die? So what is that event consist of? It is consist of more than 3, no? That is why it will be consist of 4, 5, 6. So that particular event will have the values as 4, 5, 6, okay? So like that, event is any collection of one or more simple events, okay? So this is the figure we use to explain what is sample space and what is a simple event and what is event, okay? Now we see these examples, okay? So when experiment, toss a coin 10 times. When you toss a coin 10 times and the number of heads is observed. So since you are tossing a coin 10 times, maximum number of heads occur will be 10, no? Okay, so sometimes we will not get one head also. So number of times we get head will be from 0 to 10. Okay, so the sample space will have 11 elements now. What is the sample space now? It will be having 11 elements. That is 0, 1, 2, 3, so 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, because we are tossing a coin 10 times. Okay, for example, here, that is particular event will have odd number of, what is the probability of getting even number of heads? Okay, so that is 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 is A. And what is B? B is nothing but what is the probability of getting odd number of head when you toss a coin 10 times? Okay, that is 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. Okay. So these are the number of times we will be getting head, odd number of times a head is occurring when you toss a coin 10 times. And similarly, C is having the values 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What is that? Here we are, what is the probability of getting a head when you toss a coin 10 times with the value less than 6? Okay. So it is having the values from 0 to 5. It is having the values, all the values less than 6. Okay. Now you find out what is A union B. If you find out A union B, we will be getting sample space. Here we are denoting sample space with the ohm. Okay. So we will be getting a sample space. It is having the values from 0 to 10. So in the previous, just now we have discussed that. What is sample space? Sample space will be having all the values from 0 to 10 because we are tossing the coin 10 times. What is the maximum number of getting head will be 10 times. What is the minimum number of getting head will be 0 times. We know we will not get head once also, or sometimes we will be getting 0 or head 10 times. So number of times getting head will be varying from 0 to 10. So what is A union B will be equal to sample space. What is A intersection B? Because A is, in the A, we will be checking for how many even number of times we are getting head. In B, we are checking for how many odd number of times we are getting head. Okay, that is why A intersection B will be having no outcomes. Okay, so if you don't have any outcomes in common, then what is that called? A and B are called mutually exclusive. Okay. So what is mutually exclusive? Events, when event A intersection event B is equal to null set. Okay, no elements means what? No elements means what? it does not contain any element. So it means it is null set. Okay. If A intersection B is null set, then we say that A and B are mutually exclusive. Yes or no? Now, can you tell me what is C complement? C complement is given as, so the elements of elements in the sample space other than elements in C. So what are the elements in C? It is from 0 to 5. What is sample space? The sample space will have the values from 0 to 10. Okay. So whatever elements containing in sample space other than in C is nothing but C complement. Okay. So here 0 to 5 we have elements. You know? Now the remaining elements are 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 will be in the C complement. Okay. Similarly, A intersection C is given as 0 to 4. Yes or no? 0 to 4 is common between A and C. That is why A intersection C is given as 0 to 4. It means that what A and C are not mutually exclusive. A and C are not mutually exclusive. Okay. When these two are mutually exclusive, what happens? Their intersection will be equal to null set. Okay. See this example. When you toss a coin three times, the sample space is given like this. So we'll be getting all the three heads. So these are the different possibilities. We are sampling.